Hi everybody, welcome to another evening with Sips. Tonight we're taking a look at the Beginner's Guide. Oh man, I'm pretty excited about this. This is the latest and the greatest by the guy who made the Stanley Parable. The guy? The guys? The studio? Can you just say the guy? I have no idea. Anyway, Stanley Parable guys have made this. It just came out yesterday. I think it was supposed to come out yesterday. Maybe it's only just been available on Steam today. Anyway, I was really excited. I picked it up on Steam this morning. I installed it, and I am ready to begin the game. Apparently, it's not a very long game. I paid about £5 for this on Steam. If you're in America, that's like $7, I think. I don't know. Apparently, it's like an hour and a half of gameplay. Maybe more. But it has no game mechanics or anything. So I'm intrigued. Already intrigued. That is such a sales pitch, isn't it? Hey, buy this game, there's no game mechanics. And it's only an hour and a half long. It's probably going to be pretty good, though. The Beginner's Guide. All right, I am ready. Begin the game. Take me to the bridge. Imagine a fucking bridge just appeared right now. Please make sure audio is on. It is. I can hear the birds chirping. Oh, man, I hope this isn't like Ethan Carter. Controls. W, A, S, and D. And mouse button. Okay, nice and easy. Force tutorial. Check.
Hi there. Thank you very much for playing the Beginner's Guide.
No problem.
My name is Davey Reedon.
Hi, Davey.
I wrote the Stanley Parable.
Oh.
And while that game tells a pretty absurd story, today I'm going to tell you about a series of events that happened between 2008 and 2011.
Are the series of events absurd?
We're going
absurd?
To look at the games made by a friend of mine named Coda.
Coda.
Now, these games mean a lot to me. I met Coda in early 2009 at a time when I was really struggling with some personal stuff, and his work pointed me in a very powerful direction. I found it to be a good reference point for the kinds of creative works that I wanted to make.
Huh.
So just to start you off, this is, I think, the first game he ever made. It's a level for Counter-Strike.
Oh, nice. I was going to say, it's Counter-Strike.
And mostly it's just Coda
dust.
Learning the basics of building a 3D environment.
Coda made Dust.
What I like is that even though he starts from the simple aesthetic of a desert town, he then scatters these colorful abstract blobs and impossible floating crates around the level. And of course, it destroys the illusion that this actually is a desert town, and instead this level becomes a kind of calling card from its creator. It's like a reminder that this video game was constructed by a real person.
Oh.
And it kind of makes you wonder, what was going through his head as he was building this?
Well,
this is what I like about all of Coda's games. I mean, not that they're all fascinating as games, but that they are all going to give us access to their creator.
That just looks like he made a mistake.
I want us to see past the games themselves. I want to get to know who this human being really is.
Oh.
And that's exactly what we're going to do here.
We're going to explore Coda.
It's 2008. Coda starts making these games, and he never releases any of them. He doesn't put them onto the internet. He just makes them and then immediately abandons them, and they sit on his computer forever.
Oh.
And I think he really understood this image
that's
of himself
sad,
as a recluse. At one point, he jokingly renamed his computer's recycling bin to Important Games Folder.
Nice.
So, you know, this was just how he worked. He tended to crank them out one after the other without even really pausing to try to understand what he had just made. Until suddenly one day, he just stopped. In 2011, that was it. He made his last game, and then he hasn't made another one since. And that's why I've taken this opportunity to gather all of his work together, is because I find his games powerful and interesting, and I'd like this collection to reach him, to maybe encourage him to start creating again.
Oh.
And if the people like you who play this also happen to find his work interesting, then I'm sure it'll just send that much stronger of a message of encouragement to Coda. So thanks for joining me on this. If you have a particular interpretation that I haven't mentioned here, or if you just need to get in touch, you can email me at daveywreden@gmail.com. Okay, that's about it for introduction. Let's take a look at Coda's first proper game.
Okay,
as each game is loading, I'll show you the date that it was completed. This first one was made in November 2008.
Oh my god. Is it going to be Counter-Strike Source Map? Okay, he made this game in 2008. Warning, Whisper Machine status active. Evacuate immediately. What? Whisper Machine status?
Warning, hey. Whisper Machine active.
What? What the fuck? What do I do here?
This game is called Escape from Whisper, and it's one of the more generic games you'll see from Coda.
Holy fuck, he made this whole thing? This is crazy. Look at this. I couldn't fucking do this if my life depended on it. Literally, if there was a man standing behind me right now with a gun to my head and said, make...
You can click to fire the gun.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, no, I could not fucking do this. As much as I would love to be able to do this. Uh-oh. Okay, we've got alien life forms inbound. Can I go through?
It kind of looks like this game was abandoned mid-development.
Kinda.
For instance, you have this gun, which you'd think would indicate that there are supposed to be monsters or enemies somewhere. But
yeah.
But then clearly there are no enemies anywhere.
No.
You can't even reload the gun when you run out of bullets. But ultimately we don't really know. Maybe Coda thought that actually it was complete the way that it is. And I think that we should talk about his games for what they are, rather than for what they're not.
Well, I mean, I appreciate that, but I mean, this is obviously not done.
I love how you can see the bottom of the universe from this room.
Can you? Oh yeah, you fucking can. That's so good. Oh, Jesus Christ. Okay, which way do I go now? Dude, this is like, what is this? What are these fucking dots on the wall for? Maybe, oh, something open? No? Oh yeah, opens. I mean, I say that this is not done, but it's pretty close. Like, you just add a couple of sprites in here, and then
apparently
pop, pop,
the space station has a labyrinth on it.
Why not?
Sure, I don't know. There's
why
really no reason
not?
For it that I've ever been able to discern, so in the interest of time, I'm just gonna skip you on past it.
Well, okay, fine. You say that, but that's a really good defense. It's a solid defense, having a labyrinth, right? Like, imagine you're on, like, a Corellian Corvette and Darth Vader's Star Destroyer, tractor beams you, and then they board you. If you've got a fucking labyrinth on there, those stormtroopers are never gonna fucking find you in time to, seize you before you get into the escape pod. Am I right? Or am I right? Those are the only two options.
Okay, anyway. This is the part that's interesting.
Oh yeah.
The game has this narrative about the whisper machine, and how it has to be turned off, and then you get to the engine room.
Right. Oh yeah. Is that where all the whispers are coming from? Ah, shit, is this gonna trigger my ASMR like there's no tomorrow? Is there a woman in there, like, cooking me pancakes and, like, fucking massaging her bunions or whatever?
Hey, you there, in the engine room. You could save us all.
Sorry, can you whisper, please?
A whisper machine.
Oh.
We could disrupt it by introducing a great enough heat signature. If you... your body could stop the beam.
No. What?
It's so much to ask, but for all of our lives, would you do it? Could you give yourself?
No! I'm the fucking hero around here! Jeez, who's gonna stop the stormtroopers when they come onto the- Okay, fine. I'm dead.
Let me pause here for a second.
Okay.
What you just experienced, stepping into the beam and then dying,
yeah,
is probably what Coda had initially intended when he was developing this level. But when he first compiles and plays it, something goes wrong. There's a bug somewhere.
The labyrinth?
And this is what happens instead.
Oh. What happened? Oh. Just like non-stop. Look. Oh, I see. Hey, watch out. Oh, man. Hey, there is a labyrinth on this space station. And look, it's a tricky one, too.
The beam causes him to start floating.
Uh-oh.
And this is an important moment for him. Because, yes, this is technically a glitch.
Yeah.
But Coda identifies something human about it. Like how small it makes you feel in the face of this larger chaotic system.
Oh, okay.
Or this floating could be the afterlife, a peaceful place, juxtaposed against all of the hysteria that you've just had to traverse.
Oh.
I don't even know. I have no idea what he was thinking. But what's clear is that after making this, something lodges itself in his brain.
Right.
He wants to do more of these really weird and experimental designs. So he stops work on this and moves on to a stream of tiny little games that go in all sorts of directions.
Oh.
Let's go ahead and take a look at the first game he made after leaving this one behind.
So do you think maybe the floating bug just sort of put him off and he's like, oh, fuck this floating bug. Oh my god. What engine does he use? It's like Unity or something, or Unreal or Source, or the past was behind her. I can't move. Oh.
In this game, you can only walk backwards.
Oh, I was gonna say, yeah, I can only walk backwards. Can I walk past through the wall? Oh, I see. You have to, like... Oh, for fuck's sakes, Coda. Jeez, I don't want to play this. What the hell? I can't see what's in front of me. Well, I technically can actually see what's in... What?
So it's a short and relatively minimalist experiment combining motion and narrative.
Right, okay.
It is less advanced than the previous game, but actually it seems to be more focused, more complete. Code is trying to give it a unique voice rather than simply basing it on a pre-existing trope.
Right. The music is crazy too. It sounds like all... When she stops and looks, it becomes clearer. Okay, let's go up the... This is cool, actually. But if the future is always behind her, oh, how will she find the strength? Oh, shit. That's a good question. To confront it.
It's a short little thought. It says what it wants to say, and then it ends. Didn't need anything more than that.
Nice.
Which, to me, is why it works. Because it gets out quick.
Right.
Okay, next one.
All right, I'm ready. Still November 2008. Man, Coda is a fucking beast. This guy makes games. Oh, fuck. Is this Slenderman? It is. You are now entering. Oh, shit. Get ready for the jump scares. You are now entering.
And that's it. Okay, the meaning of this game won't be clear just yet. Please be patient with me for a few more games, and I promise you'll see what makes it interesting.
All right. I'm on board for the ride. So far, this is very compelling to me. I like this.
Oftentimes, Coda would put bizarre titles like this one at the start of his games.
Right. Nonsense nearly every direction.
Well, I wish I'd known him at the time that he was making these early games. He would really only talk to me about his work as he was making it. Once he stopped work on a game, like, that was it. It was dead to him. And I don't agree with that at all, but what are you gonna do?
No, true. I mean, fair enough. Okay, so we walk up this big staircase. That's the thing, I mean, you gotta let a man do what he's gonna do, right? If he doesn't want to make a fucking game, oh shit, look, you slow down.
Once you've been slowed to an absolute crawl, the door at the top of the stairs opens.
Oh,
so why, if Coda's not showing these games to anyone, why bother opening the door at all? Well, to show you, I'm modifying the game here so that when you press enter, it'll bring you back up to full speed so you can enter the door for yourself.
Okay. Because I don't want to crawl up, but I need to know what's inside this door now. Ha ha! It's a penthouse! Stand on an X staring at a bear for 3 hours. A stranger appears. You must... Whoa, you start in a small room until you realize you can just walk through the walls. Can I? No, I can't. You walk around...
That's warm and nice and filled with little ideas for games.
You construct a wall. The wall is destroyed. You are given a medal. Game filled with chairs, except
Coda
one chair is floating.
Tell me that he didn't mind if people thought of him as cold or distant. He said that he knew that he was actually a vibrant and compassionate person, but that it takes time to really see that.
Oh, that's true,
isn't it? It can be a very slow climb to get there.
Oh, okay, get it. Read an enemy's emails to learn how to beat them. Haha, that's so good. Sharks are trying to eat you. Simultaneously, you are trying to eat the sharks. Oh my god, that's so good. Ready, set, fish. Wait. Okay, I was promised fishing. Oh, fuck, it's the space station labyrinth again, isn't it? No? I mean, this is straight up something out of, like, Dark Forces. Remember that game, Dark Forces? Maybe, like, TTT? It's gotta
be
Source, right?
Coda. It's an actual puzzle.
Okay.
Go ahead and see if you can solve it.
Okay, I solved it. There's a whole bunch of mist here. Can I just go into the mist? No? I guess I have to, like, hit this again. Get into here with the door closed and then hit this one on the other side.
Don't forget that solution, because we're going to see this puzzle again soon.
That's
we're gonna see it a lot.
Right, I mean, it's a pretty easy one. Okay, so I have to do the same thing here. How do I open this door now? It's already open. Puzzle solved. Oh, shit.
So that seems to be it, right?
Yeah.
You walk down a corridor, you solve a puzzle, you get to the end. Simple enough.
Yeah.
All right. Now I'm going to modify the game again, so that when you press enter, it'll remove all of the walls from this room.
Okay, get ready for Goatsy. No, there's no Goatsy. It's just like a million fucking puzzles. It's like Portal. Basically, Coda, like, thought of Portal before
Portal. How
about
that? There was more to it than we had any way of knowing.
That's true, yeah, there's
lots.
I
actually find it funny that this game comes after the Stairs game, since they essentially convey the opposite idea.
Yeah, right.
So, in the Stairs game, a dull exterior concealed a rich interior. And then, in this level, a dull interior hides this fantastic outer world.
Yeah, yeah, look at it. Holy
Either
shit.
Either way, I think that the point is the same. Is that most of the time, you don't get to know what you're missing. Or even that you're missing anything. That's not your role as a player. So no. If your role here is not to understand, then what is it?
I want to eat the sharks while they're trying to eat me. That's the one I want to play. Ah, shit, we're back. Okay, so this is like a jump scary game for sure, right? You're now exiting. Oh, wait, okay, we're leaving now.
Aha. So, this, combined with the entering game from earlier, tells us that Coda believes his games are connected somehow.
Oh, cool.
It could even be that the stairs game and the puzzle game are literally connected in between this and the entering game. There's a bigger picture that all of his games are meant to play a role in. Some larger meaning that we won't be able to grasp until we've seen all of them. And once we have, we can step back and start to understand what exactly that bigger picture is.
Oh man, this is such a cool idea for a game. This is so neat. The Great and Lovely Descent. Oh, is this going to be like a... Oh, look at that. This is what sold me on this game. This screenshot of the house. I just thought, oh, this could be fucking awesome. Oh shit, you can... Oh, okay, you can actually move around. Oh man, this is kind of spooky, actually. What is that?
Let's talk about video game development for a second.
Okay, I'm ready.
Every video game runs on what's called an engine, which determines what the game can and cannot do.
Uh-huh.
So in other words, the engine is a set of tools for game development.
Okay.
To make all of these games, Coda is using an engine called Source.
Oh, okay, it is
like
Source.
All engines, Source has certain things that it does well, and it has certain things that it does poorly. One of the things that it does very well is boxy linear corridors.
Nice.
That's why so many of Coda's games are set in these large, flat, empty rooms, is just because he's working with what the engine does well.
Cool. Okay. The streetwise
tools available to the creator shape what kinds of creative work they're going to end up making. You might consider paying attention to the architecture in Coda's games to notice how they seem to stem from an engine that's very good at producing linear boxy corridors.
Yeah, I mean, Stanley Parable was like that too, right? That was a Source game too. Okay. Down we go. Oh yeah, here's the very... Wow, the basement to the streetwise fool is crazy. Can I jump? Oh yeah, look. It's a game about jumping. There we go. Spacebar to jump on this one. Just in case you're wondering. Oh shit, I think you can actually maybe die here. Gotta be careful. Okay. And then we want to go like down here. Oh crap, no. I almost died. Can I even die though? Is it worth trying to die? Or do we want to just like really try hard our way through this level? Man, this is pretty cool actually. Oh, okay, we have to like go here, down here. Wonderful. Okay. Oh, man, we're almost at the end. I can't believe it. I can almost taste it. What's going to be at the end? Maybe more of that Slenderman game. I don't even know if I really want to play that Slenderman game again. This is kind of scary. Down here, and then I guess like over there is like the safest bet? Or is it? I don't think I can actually get to like... Hey, I did it. Whoa. Oh, I guess you want to get down to the bottom here because look, there's like something down here. What is this? Hey, what is that? Oh, cool. It's like a... Oh, neat. Hey, look at this. Oh, fuck. It looks like Gatwick Airport. Ever been there before? Anyway, it looks just like that. Not so much this part, but... Ah, oh, sweet. What is this? Oh, look. The little gate opens. Oh, is this like a jail or something? It's a jail for horses. Oh, horse jail. Hey, Coda, if you ever make games again, make a game about horses in a jail. That would be pretty cool. Oh, this little elevator. Oh, it takes you all the way. Oh, neat. We don't want to go in there, though, do we? Oh, yeah, I guess we do.
This prison, funny enough, in Coda's original design, the door stayed shut for a full hour before letting you go.
Oh, my God.
If you don't mind, I think we're going to skip that.
Yeah, no, that's fine. Oh, I guess we go back
this
down?
This is something that he and I used to argue about a lot. You know, whether a game ought to actually be playable. Whether it means anything if no one can get through it. And I would always defend that, you know, all this work goes into the game, why not make it playable and accessible?
Yeah,
and so we just got into heated arguments over it. There was one time that after one of these conversations, he went home, and a day or two later, he sent me a zip file entitled Playable Games. That was full of hundreds of individual games, each of which was just an empty box that you walked around in and nothing else.
Oh my God.
Believe me, I replayed every single one of those just to find out if there was like a gag hidden somewhere.
And there wasn't. Oh my god. Holy shit. Okay, fine. We're outside now. And I guess this is what you discover after being, hey, look at
it. Again.
It's back.
With the exact same solution as the last time.
Oh, really? How did I solve it last time? I don't remember. Oh, yeah, I did this. You have to, like, go in, close it, and then open it
There's
up
There's still
again.
No clear indication of what makes this puzzle so special that Coda is going to return to it over and over. But I promise I'll share with you my interpretation very shortly.
I think that he wanted to make a puzzle game, and that was just like an introductory puzzle, and just because he'd done it and he was happy with it and maybe lost interest in the project, he was just like, okay, well, you know, I've got this puzzle, I might as well just use it again, like in other places. You there, did you come from up above?
Here, Coda
what
begins
was up
using
there?
A kind of dialogue system that he fashioned out of the engine's chat capabilities.
Oh, neat.
Use the 1, 2, 3 buttons on your keyboard to respond.
Yes, there was an enormous prison I spent hours in. Nice. That's the world above. You've been there. Now, this is important. Did you have to get through a puzzle with 2 doors and switches? Yes, I did. That was literally the last thing I did before coming here. Nice. Again, perfect. Now, please tell us how you solved it. Tell us the solution. Tell us how to get to the other side. I don't remember how I solved it. I'm trying to remember again. I didn't solve it. Someone else let me in. Trust me, you don't want to go over there. Let's go with 3, I guess. Uh-oh, they're gonna get angry now. Oh no, but I do, we do! We need to get there, do you understand? It's the most important thing in the world, we have to escape this prison! There must be an ending, I promise you! There is nothing I want more! Oh my god, these guys really- Oh, I love how the little thing tilts, it says like, speak, listen. So these guys are in jail, it's not a bad jail though, I mean, look at this, it's alright in here. Get some drinks, they got like a heater and stuff, it's fucking sweet. Alright, in we go. Oh shit, there's more. Oh god, this is creepy as shit. It's the same fucking room. Hello, how did you get here? Was there a puzzle you had to pass through? Yes, do you want to know how to solve it? Nice. No, no, we actually find the black space between the doors to be far more interesting. Have you seen it yet? Actually, now that you mention it, I remember feeling strange as I passed through it. Don't think too hard about it. Okay, fine, I'll try not to. You'll see it again soon. Oh shit, does that mean it's like... Yeah, open up. Oh, sweet. Is this gonna be the fucking door switch puzzle again? Oh, please. Please, I need it. I'll spend another hour in jail. I need to do this puzzle again.
And so we make one last descent down to the final floor of the level.
Okay. That music is really creepy, isn't it? Alright, what's down here? I hope it's the puzzle. Oh, no, it's not. Man, it must have taken him a while to build some of this stuff. Like, look at, like, I guess he did, like, some stuff with the hammer editor and stuff for, like, making levels in Counter-Strike or whatever. Oh, god.
It's a lamppost.
Yeah, no, I can see that, but...
I can't tell you quite why, but for some reason, Coda fixates on this lamppost.
Okay.
It's going to appear at the end of every single one of his games from here on out.
Oh.
I'll tell you what I think. I think that up to this point, you know, he's been making really strange and abstract games with no clear purpose, and maybe you can only float around in that headspace for so long.
Right.
Because now he wants something to hold on to. He wants a reference point. He wants the work to be leading to something.
Oh.
He wants a destination, which is what this lamppost is. It's a destination. We're going to see it in the work as well. His games are just going to become a lot more cohesive, a lot more fully developed, with more of a clear idea behind them.
Right, okay.
And as we go, that idea will get clearer and clearer and clearer.
Nice. Oh, shit. Okay. Really dramatic fade as well. Okay. I'm ready. I'm ready for cohesive, clear games, but at the same time, I'm ready for abstract ones too. This game is connected to the internet. As you walk around, you can leave notes. All notes you see are left by other players. Oh, nice. Where are these notes? Oh, I see one. Here's a note. What does it say? Nice room. Not. Oh, it's not very nice. I mean, it's not actually a very nice room.
So first off, I'm sure you can deduce this, but this game is not connected to the internet. All of the notes that you're gonna see have been written by Coda.
Okay.
This
How'd
was
you beat
actually
this game?
The first game of his that I ever played. This was shortly after I met him at a weekend game jam in Sacramento, where I grew up. I saw him working on this very level, and it was just so different from anything that anyone else was doing. So right away I was like, I have to be friends with this person.
Nice.
In retrospect, I think I was probably a bit too pushy trying to get his attention. I was over-enthusiastic.
Did you push
But he was very gracious about it and very patient with me.
Oh, that's good.
And I cooled off eventually.
All right, okay. How do you beat this game? No point to this. Oh, look. All of these have been left by players, but not actually by players because they've all been written by Coda, apparently. Whoa. Holy shit. Can you guys hear me? Maybe this is gonna get really sinister. Hello. Reasonable. Oh,
feel free to skip over any of these notes if they're not doing anything for you. Nothing extra is gonna happen if you read all of them. Either way, to me they convey a sense of loneliness.
They kinda do.
I see this person who's filled with thoughts and feelings and beliefs and has no way to express them except as scattered and unheard voices in a game that wasn't meant to be played.
Snow. No, yeah, I get that, actually.
But it's ironic, isn't it, that in playing this game and seeing how alone Coda often felt, that we get to know him better and actually kind of connect with him. And I have to be honest with you, this idea is really seductive to me.
Hey,
that
guys.
I could just play someone's game and see the voices in their head and get to know them better and have to do less of the messy in-person socializing.
Messy in-person socializing.
I could just get to know you through your work.
I need to go to the freaking bathroom.
I think this is why I always liked Coda's games so much, is because it felt like they let me have that connection. I felt as though he was inviting me personally into his world. And then I feel less lonely too.
A free t-shirt! Nice. Open sesame, how do I open? Sesame, open please. Need an other side door, why are you so free? Someday I'll meet the person who made this. I help people because of the internal good feeling I get. This is fucking cool, actually. New room! Do you hear the chimes? They keep you going, don't they? Yeah, I like the little chimes. I would like very much to be desired. It's not very crowded here. There's a lot of notes here. Scared of writing something. Don't want to feel judged. Oh, I see. And they go gray when you've got... You can go in here, I think. Welcome. Congratulations. I don't really know where to go with this. What about this one? A game where you leave notes and suddenly everyone's a poet. It's true, isn't it? Look at this, it's fucking nice. Look at this big painting on the wall back here. Cabbage shapes our nation. True. Hey, don't talk about me that way. Alright, so we just keep going through here? And wait for Stanley Parable to start telling us what to do? This is a note? This is pretty cool, actually. I like how all these games are like strung together or whatever. It's really cool. It's such a neat idea. Alright, we made it to the painting. Now what? You have to like stand around and admire it for... You're forced into... Watch, there's gonna be some walls that go up and you have to stand here admiring it for like an hour. We will all die someday. It doesn't mean anything. What's in here? It's a creepy tunnel. Man, it must have taken a long time to actually build all these rooms and stuff though. It's not easy doing all this stuff. It's really fucking time consuming. Well, I'm here now. Yeah, we're all here now. Oh, look, they start to trail off a little bit. There must be a reason for it, though. His terrible secret, he kept it well. I beat the game! Well, no, I say it's trailing. More room?
At the end of this level, we're going to see the puzzle again. And here, I'll tell you what I think the puzzle means. Each of these games represents an idea that was on Coda's mind at the time that he was making it.
Right.
And the puzzle is a way of closing the door on a previous chapter of his life before moving on to the next one.
Or do you think that maybe he just like had it coded and it was ready to go and
in
he was like, I know
games,
I want a puzzle here, but...
After exploring a theme that, you know, he might find difficult, Coda can then place this puzzle that he knows has a reliable solution, he understands exactly how it works, and so it gives him a simple mechanism for moving on.
Right, okay. Well, I'm gonna stick with my theory
in that...
Because
there's this dark area between the doors,
yeah.
The space between spaces, before you move on, you get to pause.
Yeah.
Just for a moment, a few seconds to reflect on and let go of the events that led you here, to step back and connect the pieces together, to grasp at that elusive bigger picture.
What the fuck? Oh, it's typewriters. The sound of typewriters getting close. How do you leave notes? I want to leave my own note. Oh, look at this. Oh, here's the lamppost as well. I mean, what if all this stuff doesn't mean anything, though? Are you there? Please say something. It can be anything. I just need you to say something. Talk to me, please. Why are you having so much difficulty talking? Speak, 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 speak. That's kind of creepy, actually. What if a lot of this stuff is just placeholder stuff, though? Maybe it's like, I know this is going to be the end, so I just use this lamppost as a placeholder.
It's going to kind of just spin its own wheels for a few minutes. Hang with it.
Okay. What did it say about porn stars at the start? I was too busy talking. Alright, I'm ready for the wheels to spin. Oh man, this is pretty cool. Does this open? Yeah, it does. Okay, in we go. Holy shit. What a pad. What a place. What a happening place. We're like getting ready for a party. We're gonna have a whole bunch of porn stars over to our party, I think. And once they get here, we're going to go into the dungeon? The hell?
See, like, this is it. The whole game. And there's nothing that's particularly interesting about it. You just walk to the end of a hallway.
Oh, can
Except
I go up here?
For some reason, Coda gets really fixated on this prison that has all of this modern furniture.
Right.
And I don't know why, but he decides he needs to revisit this prison. He's gonna start over, use the same assets, turn it into something else.
Nice.
Okay, cool. Here's version two.
All right, version two, I'm ready. Okay, so now, what furniture ought to go in the center of the room? How about a TV with surround sound? Oh, nice! That's not a TV, though. It's just a table. Okay, now what about along the wall of the room? Let's put a huge picture of a horse. That's not a huge picture of a horse. I think we should light up this room a bit. We'll put live Tesla coils in each corner. Yeah. Yeah. That's right. That's not a Tesla coil. And a table, you need a table. We already have one. Who are you? Where exactly are you doing this from? Oh, yeah, that's another table, I guess. Oh, shit. Hey, look at this.
There's a bit more to this one, but still, it's not really communicating anything. It's kind of just
that's
weird.
That's awesome. Look at all
sake.
The furniture. It's like that warehouse from Raiders of the Lost Ark, or was it the Temple of Doom?
So, okay, he or throws it out and starts crusade. Over. This time he comes at the prison idea from a different direction.
Alright. I'm set. Hello, please walk forward. No problem. This guide will enable you to escape any prison environment. Follow the instructions carefully. Take care that you remember each step. First, click on this table. No problem. Good. Go over to the photo frame and click to turn it slightly. Where's the photo frame? Where the fuck is it? Is it this thing? Now, turn the floor lamp in this room off, then turn it back on. Okay, no problem. Now, go to the left side sofa, move it over a little. Okay. Finally, touch the shelves. That's it. In real prison, the escape will now open. Return to the start to be taken back to your prison. Oh, no. No, 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 no. I have to go back to my prison. Return. I've done it. Oh man, I followed all those instructions so well. Oh shit.
And of course, now the table is gone and you can't begin the chain of events to escape.
Oh shit!
There's a version where there are no bars, but you can't actually get to the well.
Why not?
And a version where the inside of the prison is the outside and the outside is the inside.
Oh, nice.
Let me just blink you real quick through a few more of these. I mean, he really unloaded on this prison idea. There's nearly a dozen of them. Personally, I think it's awful to watch this. To see a person basically unraveling through their work. And for what? Like, at what point do you just go, maybe there are game ideas other than this prison that I could be working on?
But yeah, I don't know. It's like upside
down.
Voice
telling you to stop. That particular mechanism of defense against yourself. Without it, you just spiral. And so he keeps going and going and going and going and going, and then he hits on something.
Uh-oh.
And he likes it. And that's it. He's done. He stops making prisons.
Okay.
This is the very last version of the prison game that he created. And the reason I think it works is that the prison is not actually in it.
Okay. Jesus Christ. Okay, so this is the last iteration of the prison game. This time with 100% less prison. Alright. Oh, listen, you can hear like the chirping and stuff getting... Is this it? Okay, so this is a game where you walk from the start to a phone box and the lamppost, which is usually the indication that you're at the end of the game in a CODA game. Oh, yeah. Hop in. Oh, I get it. Hello? Who is this? Sarah Connor. Circa 1982. Hello? Who is this? Hey, it's me. I'm you from after you escaped the prison. You're me? Dot, dot, dot. So you were trapped in this prison too? Yep, I was in the furniture maze.
It's a conversation.
Yep, I was in the escape
and
tutorial.
So this is what CODA wants, is to be able to talk to someone, to share what's on his mind, and to get some good advice from someone who knows. But the irony is that even in this scenario, you're still talking to yourself. You know, all of these games so far are CODA talking to himself.
Right, okay. Yep, I was in the reverse prison. That's where I am right now. Oh, I'm so glad to know that I get out eventually. What's it like to escape? It's everything I thought it would be and more. Actually, I'm already forgetting what being in the prison was like. It's strange, but in a way, I kind of miss being in the prison. Actually, I do kind of miss being in that prison. It was pretty nice. Why? Was there anything about it that you felt good about? Being here sucks. True, maybe I only like things once I don't have them anymore. It was comfortable. I knew its limits. I knew my place. But don't you feel excited about getting out? The promise of freedom? Maybe I only like things once I don't have them anymore. That's like a pretty typical thing, isn't it? Like a lot of people feel like that. I do that too, I guess. But is that just how I'm going to be forever? I'd really like to change that. No, I think you'll find a way to change. Maybe? Wait, if you're me, then did you get a call from another version of you when you were trapped? Yes, I did get a call. That's how I escaped. Uh-oh. Oh my god. What did they tell you? What did you have to do to get out? All they told me was to be sincere. They asked me how I felt about being in prison. They just talked to me for a while. What? That freed you? How does that work? Listen, you can't know until you're out, but I promise it works. Just talk to me. Oh, I see. Okay, I can talk. Let's just talk for a bit. Will you be here? I will be here for as long as you need. That's it. Oh, man.
I can see why he considers this a fitting conclusion to the prison games. After all of the obsession and frustration, just to be told by someone you can trust that things are going to be okay. Wouldn't that be nice?
Yeah, I guess it would, actually. So are we starting to realize that CODA is maybe a bit lonely?
So what would it look like if CODA wanted to make a game about talking to someone other than himself?
Oh shit, I hope he's not going to start creating like some virtual like woman or something. As fun as that would be to mess around with in a game, but...
To me, this environment is meant to represent CODA's puzzle, with the two doors on either side and a dark transitional space between.
Oh, okay, yeah, the dark transitional space, I get that. And then there's like the fucking door puzzle is up there again, isn't it? Hey, look, this is pretty cool, though. This would make a pretty cool map for, like, Counter-Strike or something, wouldn't it? Oh, shit, that's pretty spooky. Oh, my God. Well, my goodness, I'm glad as all heck you showed up. Thought I might be having to clean this entire house all by myself. And right miserable that would have been. Everyone knows loathsome hands make lousy homes. Don't worry about me, a place this nice...
You'll notice that the quality of the art is a step up from previous games.
It is, actually,
including this new and improved chat system, which he started using from this point on.
It's nice, yeah.
From here on out, he begins putting much more effort into the visual polish of his work. And this particular game took 2 months to create as a result.
Oh, wow. Don't worry about me, a place this nice, I'll be glad to stay here all night. And lousy homes make home loners. Are we cleaning this whole place? This is an important question. That's the story, little one. Oh, don't you worry now. We'll be through this mess in no time. I promise you, you'll wish there was more. Why don't I finish up here? In the meantime, could you please clear the table? Okay. Done it. Much nicer. That's the table I want to see. Now, would you please run into the bedroom and make the bed? Yeah, sure, no problem. We'll be right back. think the bedroom is like over here, if I remember correctly. There we go. Okay, I've done it. While you're in there, why don't you straighten out the rug a bit? Sure, no problem. All the little details matter. Do you enjoy being a house cleaner? How'd you end up doing this job? It's been a long time since I've seen a house this messy. This line of work, you let go of those judgments pretty fast. May not be your apartment, but something in your life needs straightening up. You think you've got something, nothing that needs cleaning, be careful because that means it's everything. Any rate, my place is just to see a bit of peace brought here. Speaking of which, the pillows on this couch are a wreck. Would you come out and straighten them up? Sure. These ones, you mean? Oh yeah, that's better. Oh dear, looks like someone spilled a drink over by the couch. Maybe mop that up as long as you're over there. Why am I doing all the work? Hey! Come on! This is meant to be a team effort. Why am I doing everything? I feel compelled to share an incredibly cheesy personal insight. You okay with that? Make it especially cheesy, please. Dot, dot, dot. Oh my god, here he comes. Dot, dot, dot. No. No, it was stupid. Sorry, never mind. Oh. Hey, these dishes need to be washed. Why don't you come do that? Hey, you fucking do them. You're right there. Jeez. Anyway, I've done them. Last I checked, the tub needed a cleaning. How about you scrub it down as best you can? No need to be perfect. We're all just human. Where the hell is the tub? I don't even know. Is it in here? Yeah, here's the tub. Scrub the tub. Okay, tub scrubbed. Are there still books scattered on the floor of the bedroom? If so, would you put them back on the shelf? Oh, for God's sake. Jeez. I've arranged the whole shelf now. Perfect. Now then, how about come and clear these dishes off the table?
After the intense set of prison games, this house cleaning level almost feels like cleansing. It's the moment after a particularly difficult or traumatic experience where you just need to let it sit and digest inside of you, and eventually cohere into something meaningful.
I like the music and stuff. Not sure about it being so dark and spooky out there. Now then, how about you come and clear those dishes off the table? Are all houses this easy to clean? Darling, let me tell you something. In your lifetime, you're going to clean a lot of houses. And among all of those, a few of them will stick out as truly wonderful, beautiful experiences. And none of them will be the ones that were easy. Just something to think about while you smooth out the rug in the bedroom.
I know that Coda really liked this game. Of all of his work, actually, this was the only one that he called me up to ask me to come over and look at it. This was during a period of a few months where he was, like, grossly happy all the time. Just walked around with a constant smile on his face.
Nice. Alright, I have to go smooth out the rug in the bedroom. This is almost like a prison in itself, though, isn't it? Because, like, it's just like this never-ending hell of cleaning up a house. Looks like the tub has gotten rather dirty. Would you mind tidying it up a bit? Yeah, sure. Whatever. I've tidied up the tub again. Dot, dot, dot. By the way, I'm your dad. Earlier when I said I had a really cheesy thought, I was going to say it occurs to me that that one's house is a lot like one's soul. You take care of it, and it takes care of you. Heh. Don't know why I felt so weird about saying that. I get it. That's a weird thing to say to someone you just met. Yeah, you're right. That's pretty cheesy. But there's a bit of truth in it, no? Oh, here we go. Dot, dot, dot. Anyway. So. Housekeeping. Let's keep doing this. Books. Would you please clean up the books? Thanks. Oh, look, he's not so cheery anymore. Look, he's starting to be like a bit more robotic now. Okay, done. You don't have to say thanks ahead. Oh goodness, those pillows over on the couch are a real mess. Would you go over and straighten them up a bit?
I'm glad I found some peace.
Can't have the folks coming home to a messy couch. Done. What next? Is there like a timer or something? Am I doing this like faster than anyone else has ever done it? Question. Do you enjoy this?
Of course, it can't last. The music stops, your companion is gone, it's time to leave. The door at the top of the hill is now open as well.
Can I go through here?
You can't stay in the dark space for too long. You just can't. You have to keep moving. It's how you stay alive.
Right. Okay, so I move through. It's not the door puzzle. I was wrong about that. It is not the... Oh, and then the lamppost. Which is the
whole point of the puzzle doors, right? That sooner or later you have to pick up and move.
Oh, I guess so, yeah. It's
really
one way of looking at it.
I really thought that was the point of it.
You thought that was the point of it? Well, like, I mean, I get that. Items you love this at members only prices. Okay. Why did you come here today? Was it to improve your life? Was it to get a better job? Was it to make your relationships more meaningful? No. You came here to become perfect! Nice. This workshop is going to teach you... Whoa. What the fuck? I want your friends, the people in your life to look at you and think, wow, this person is a better human being than I am. Right now, who do you think about that way in your own life? Who do you know who is so well developed as a person that they make you feel disgusted with yourself, compared to whom you feel useless, selfish, ungrateful? I intend to make you into that person. Perfection is within your grasp. Oh man, for me that's Tom Cruise. And the question is not how we do we do it, but how do we do it effortlessly? This is easy. It is so easy. It is so
easy. About halfway
through
the game,
being perfect is effortless.
Shifts.
Yeah. And then we become the... Oh! This is the key. How do I achieve it with no effort? Listen to this!
As the teacher. And suddenly, you discover that your teacher is just as bigoted and afraid as you are.
This is awesome!
And also, you can move around the classroom now.
Oh, nice. Well, let me tell you right now, it isn't effortless. Then it's not the right answer. Here we go. If you are torturing yourself trying to find the right solutions for your life, you're not doing it right. Aw, yeah, here we go. Look, I can do a little dance. Seek out only one thing. What is the easiest, simplest path forward? This is crazy. There's no truth. There's no path. Hey, look, that guy is really listening, too. Do what is easiest. Do what is simplest. Feel what is true. Nice. Do we get sucked into that eventually? Nothing. No one.
I fell pretty hard for this one. I feel like it's one of the most relatable experiences that you can have.
Perfection.
Assume that some other person is perfect and totally fulfilled in every way.
That's true,
and
though.
And completely miss all of the little flaws that make them painfully human.
Yeah, no, it's easy to look at other
people.
I think about
this game a lot these days.
Yeah. It is easy to look at other people and think that they're perfect and they have no problems or whatever, right? But like
this
everybody
does. This
one took
a lot longer than all the others for Coda to make. It was 4 months between this and the last one. That's
Whoa.
Twice as long as it took him to make any other game before this. And it's not like it's particularly complex, so I remember I found that a little strange at the time.
I would have thought that the longest one for him to make would have been the one where we were jumping on all those shapes and stuff. Just because you have to actually like put all those objects in and be able to jump on them and stuff. This one, well, actually, this is like pretty complicated. It's pretty fucking impressive that he puts these levels and stuff together because they look so fucking nice. Like, this is like something that you would probably see like in a game, you know, using a source engine. Like, look at this. Holy shit. Whoa, my God. All right, the performance is beginning. Places, please. All right. She'll be coming around. In this scene, you will be playing as me. We are at a gathering of professionals. First, you'll start out leaning against this wall. No problem. Good. Stay right there. The woman across the room in this chair is a professional photographer of animals. It's your dream to photograph animals professionally. This is your one chance to learn something from her, to gain something, to succeed. Go on. Say something to her. Hey, baby! Where is the bathroom? What are you doing? You're deflecting. You're not saying that what's actually on your mind. Stop dancing around it and have a conversation with this person. Do it again. Okay. Here are all of my hopes and my dreams. No, no, no. That's not what I said to her at all. You're completely missing the tone of the conversation. I was reserved, but I knew what I wanted. I was confident. For some reason, it was just that one moment, but I was confident. Maybe it's that you need a better feel of the setting. There were a lot of people around us. I'll give you some props to work with. These cones that bounce when you touch them will represent the people nearby. Do they bounce when you touch them? Oh yeah, they do. Now talk to her again. You must have worked really hard to get where you are. I'll bet you've learned to lean into the pain. What are some sacrifices you've had to make? That's a good one. You're messing it all up again. You'll freak her out if the conversation gets that personal that quickly. Do you not realize how important this was for me? I'll never get another opportunity like this again. Everything was riding on this. Oh, shit. I want to try something. Try stepping back from the stage. Oh, shit. Oh, I see. Great. Okay, we're done, I guess. Oh, my God. Oh, that is so spooky. Lamppost? Hello? Nice set, though. Oh, shit. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. No. Oh, no. Okay, yes, now this is working.
The game
this
ends
is
with this eerie premonition
like.
Of what's going to happen next in Coda's life. The solution to social anxiety, to fears of having to perform and having to chase success, the answer for Coda is to withdraw, to hide himself away.
Oh.
Which is what leads to scenarios like the stairs that slowed you down several games ago, where it just becomes harder and harder to access Coda's inner landscape because he keeps retreating. He just keeps backing away from possible connections to anyone other than himself.
And then he just...
To be honest, I didn't consider it very healthy when I first played this game. You know, it looked to me like he was trying to justify the idea of just disconnecting yourself from the world. And that wasn't what I wanted for him or for his games. Because I feel like a lot of his games are inviting me to connect. To connect with this person. To bring him closer. But
yeah.
What can you do? After this, Coda went off and took another 5 months to make a new game.
Okay. This is June 2010. Mobius Trip. To play this game properly, you must keep your eyes closed. Click to begin the game. All right, my eyes are closed. No, they're not really. Whoa! What's going on? Help, I'm blind! I can't die like this! Something enormous just appeared on the radar! Why did I go blind? Please, someone talk to me. Please, tell me how to solve this. There was a giant door, and then my vision went black. You can't see anything either. What is that? Please, tell me how to solve this. It's a huge door. No, it's a fucking door puzzle. Am I going to be killed by a giant door? What's going on? Captain, what can we do? What's going on?
You should probably open your eyes if you haven't already. It's pretty much impossible to solve otherwise.
I had my eyes open the whole time.
And there is a solution, by the way.
Oh, okay. Please, someone talk to me. Please, tell me how to solve this. Please, don't let this be forever. Oh, I see. We have to go down here. Okay, it all makes sense now. And we have... Am I going to be killed by the giant door? Okay, I'm ready for your door. No, I was not ready for the door. What's going on? Captain, what can we do? I can't see anything! Can we go through this little door here? I think we can, you know. Yeah, here we go. Alright, we go here. The only way to stop it is to speak something that is honest. I'm bursting! I can't keep making these! I can't keep making these. Yes, that's it! That's the truth! Oh, I see. I see. I don't feel it anymore. I'm out of ideas. It's draining
me. Like I said,
me.
I was getting concerned. First off, he's never been this explicit in his work about exactly what he's thinking.
Oh,
so
I see.
Where's that coming from?
I haven't been honest.
And even weirder, his work has potentially stopped being an outlet for him. Not like he's having trouble iterating on ideas, but he literally just can't think of new ideas anymore. And in person, he was being a lot more distant than usual.
Right? Oh.
You know how sometimes a person will just deflect anything that you say in order to keep themselves disconnected all the time? It was that kind of thing. Here was the point in my relationship with Coda where I really started to wonder if he needed my help in some way.
Oh, shit. I can't figure out how to say the thing, I guess it's going to be the one. I thought it was going to be easy. I haven't been honest. I can't figure out how to say the thing. Maybe none of these are wrong. You're doing it! It's working! I'm alone. I'm stuck in it. I have to work harder. I'm alone. I think he is alone. We're going to be okay. Oh, man.
His games are going to get more desperate from here on out.
No.
After this game, it's almost 6 months before he finishes something new.
Okay. Loading, December 2010. Hello? Where am I? What is this? Huh, nice. Where did this island come from? How do I get out of here? Hello, is anybody there? Oh, nice. Is that a person? How lovely! It's been a long time since I talked to anyone. What's wrong? You look lost. I'm completely out of ideas. When I try to create, I feel empty. I have nothing left to give to my work. Oh, man. Oh, no. What's happened? Did something change? There was a machine that kept me going and it stopped. I'm trying to find this engine that used to protect me to start it again. I wonder what would have happened in his real life that made him sort of run out of ideas or get exasperated with his work. Wait, you're looking for a machine? I think I know where it is. It isn't far. Where could it be? Huh, I can hear water. What? You have to take me to it. I need to see it to know why it stopped. This is pretty neat, actually.
If the last game featured Coda talking explicitly about his creative frustrations, this one turns it up to 11.
I can take
now,
you to
put
it.
Put yourself in my shoes playing this.
Okay.
Here's a friend whose work is exhibiting signs of struggle, frustration, anxiety, depression, even. And yet, still, he keeps making games. He keeps throwing himself into the grinder even when he clearly doesn't have the energy for it anymore. Why? What is it for?
That's a tricky one, though, isn't it? I mean, sometimes, like, when you're comfortable doing something, or you're passionate with doing something, and it doesn't pay off or take you to the places that you thought it was going to take you, you still sort of go through the motions. But you can understand the frustration and stuff like that, maybe if you're creating things and not finishing them. And that's sort of like the curse of creative people, though, isn't it? Like, if you're very creative, oftentimes you'll just do bits and pieces of something, or you'll have these grand ideas to do something, and you'll do a little bit towards them, but never like finish them or whatever. And it can be very, very frustrating. It's guarded by a difficult puzzle. If you can help me solve the puzzle, we'll find the machine. Deal? Doesn't matter what I say, does it? You're going to end up there one way or another, right? Deal. I see. Okay. Nice. We've arrived at some sort of perfect. Come along, I'll show it to you. Oh.
Because from my perspective at the time and just what I knew of him, this was a result of how isolated he was. He was in his own little bubble, just sitting at his computer all day, not really showing these games to anyone, not releasing them onto the internet. And so he didn't have anyone outside of himself to connect with. He had no outlet to ground himself on.
Oh. Hey, I recognize this. Oh, wonderful. Can you tell me how to do it? Sure, I can. First, you have to close the door. First, you have to open the door. First, you press the switch on the... Okay, first you have to open the door. Okay, now what? Well, you have to close the first door. Now you have to open the first door. You press the switch on the inside. No, now you have to close the first door, but you have to, like, go in here as well, right? Yeah. Alright, what's next? Then you have to... Now just press the switch here. Now just close the first door. Now just open the first door. Now just press the switch here. Done. Ha! That was so simple.
You can't talk yourself out of loneliness. It doesn't work that way.
No, true.
You can't be the one writing both the questions and the answers. Then there's no movement. Then there's no circulation. If all of your anxieties are being channeled into your work, then if the work ever fails, you have no backup and you're just going to crash.
Uh-oh. I can't believe I never solved it before this. Okay, here we are. This is the machine. I have nothing left to give to my work. Hello, is anyone there? Where am I? I need to see it to know why it stopped. Deal. What are you talking about? Trust me, you'll see. You have to say that your work is fun and easy. You have to say that game development is simple and joyous and that you love it 100% of the time. Okay. Making games is simple. Alright. Making games is effortless. Oh my god. Ah, oh, that feels wonderful. But it wasn't true. Why did the walls just crumble? Don't worry about it. Just keep talking. Keep saying that creation is easy. I am constantly excited and enthusiastic about my work. Boom! Yes, that's wonderful. Keep going.
Seeing this game at the time that he made it, it looked really unhealthy to me.
It does feel really unhealthy.
I was watching him do this to himself, and I hated it. I hated seeing him so trapped.
Yeah.
It's like, video games are not worth this amount of suffering.
No, that's probably true. I just never stop creating, and you just never stop creating, you'll never feel bad. It's such a simple solution. Every time I make myself make something, I feel better about myself. Boom. Perfect. That feels fantastic.
This is someone I really cared about. And I used to get so much joy out of seeing him create. For him to suddenly become angry and frustrated like this, it was the worst thing for me.
None of this is helping. I'm going to vomit. Please, where is the machine? Patience, you have to trust me. I promise this will work. Please, continue. Okay. Pain breezes effortlessly off me. Any sacrifices made for my work are worth it 100% of the time. Oh my god. Things are really breaking now. Yes, more. Keep going.
I don't know. This is what I felt at the time. I don't know how else to explain it.
Well,
I wanted it to stop more than anything. I had never felt so rotten. I needed more than I had ever needed anything for this to stop.
Yeah. There is no shame, no fear, no guilt. I will be saved by my work. Ah, incredible. That's it. I'm free. I'm free. Oh my god.
But it didn't stop.
No.
After finishing this one, Coda takes another 7 months and comes up with a new game.
Holy shit. Are we ready for the next game? Because, like, that one was pretty bad. I'm not saying it was a bad game. I'm just saying, like, it was pretty fucking hard to get through. Ma'am, glad to see you arrived safely. You've captured the machine. It's waiting for you now. You can begin the interrogation whenever you like. I intend to be quick. I intend to be quiet. I intend to be brutal. Let's go for quick. I intend to be quick. Very good. Just be warned that someone called the press, so you might have a bit of attention on this one. Also, one more thing that you should know about the machine. It calls itself Coda. Oh, okay. Oh, man. It's pretty dark. Will we get to see the machine? Please, give us answers! Blah, 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 blah! Excuse me, everybody. I'm going to do the interrogation right now. Oh, nice. Here's the machine. You stopped.
And of course, it's the machine.
There it is. You stopped. You stopped feeding us. Your work was keeping us alive. Your work was keeping us healthy. Your work was keeping us healthy. Those people out there, can you imagine what pain you've put them through? It was only because of your creations that any of us could make it through every day. How could we possibly go back to trusting you to do this job? How about this for a start? You need to go to the people who are out there and apologize to them. You have to admit to the people that you allowed them to suffer. I've been so alone. Apologize for leaving me. No? Nothing? Think carefully. I know how to hurt you. I have seen the thing you fear. Oh, I have seen the thing you fear. What is that? What is that noise in the background? Is that the machine? Alright then, I will apologize to the people on your behalf. Everybody, get ready. I'm coming out for the big apology. That's right. Ladies and gentlemen, my followers, my friends, my friends! It falls on me to deliver bad news. The machine will not apologize to us.
What?
But this is not important. We are stronger than it thinks we are. I think. Let us pay it retribution. Let us show it that we are not failures. Follow me. We will destroy the machine. Oh, maybe this is the last game. Maybe this is it. Follow me, everybody. Oh, look, we're going to destroy the machine on stage. This is nice, actually. I like this. Well. Oh, hey, we get a gun now. Okay. Pew, pew, pew. Where's the machine? Is the machine, like, out here in the crowd? Should we do, like, some crowd surfing? Can't. Oh. Oh! Oh, hey, look at this. Coda, I'll make sure your work dies here. Coda, I'll make sure you are known forever. Oh my god. Okay, so you can like shoot up the walls. Isn't that what you're scared of? Having to live without your precious creations? Having to deal with yourself? Oh my god, yeah, this is pretty
So now dark. The work is becoming self-destructive.
Yeah, really.
And I'll tell you, at the time that I first played this game, shortly after he made it, here's what I'm thinking to myself. I'm thinking that Code is stuck in his own head, and that it's having a very negative effect on him.
Yeah.
And that all he needs to do is just start showing his work to people, to get some actual feedback on his games. It might get him out of isolation.
Oh.
And so, as I'm thinking this,
oh, it's just pain.
I realize that I could be the one to initiate it.
Right.
Because it would never occur to Coda to start actively soliciting feedback, so what if I did it for him?
Right.
If he could see the difference it would make to have more actual conversations with other human beings, would that bring him out of his mental spiral? Would it give him confidence in himself? Would it bring meaning back into his work?
I think it probably would help. Okay. Oh yeah, here's the game idea room, but now it's empty. There's no ideas left. Because I guess Coda's just been sort of alluding to the fact that he's exasperated with the whole thing and doesn't have any ideas and doesn't want to do it anymore. Oh man. Oh, see, you like fall through.
So I started showing Coda's work to people. I took this one and the islands which you just played, the theater, the notes, the house cleaning game, and some of the prison escape games. I brought them to people that I knew and trusted. I asked their opinions.
Okay.
And the great part is that they really loved his games.
Wow.
You know, the point of it all was just to give him some external reference point, but they genuinely loved his work.
Oh, look.
There was nothing for him to be afraid of.
So 2011 was when he stopped, right? Oh, look, the machine is just like under here now, by the lamppost. You gotta admit, a lot of this stuff is very impressive for one person. Put down your weapon. Okay. How do I do that? G?
Can you see why I felt like this was the right thing to do? Because it's the thing that I always feel like I need. To be told that my work is good. That I am good.
No, I mean, I think everyone feels that.
When someone really connects with a thing that I've made, when they see themselves purely in my work, there's nothing that feels better. And I got to give that very same feeling to my friend. I did something... I really felt like I'd done something good. Like I was a good person. I felt like there was a friend who was in trouble and was unhappy and maybe didn't like themselves, and I could fix it. If I could give him this gift, maybe I could fix the problem.
Well, it's fair enough.
Told me how much they enjoyed his games, it was the best feeling. It was the absolute best feeling. It made me feel so happy. So beautifully, beautifully happy.
But? Oh.
So anyway, Coda finishes this game, and then really he just kind of takes off for a while.
Uh-oh.
So this is June of 2011, and I didn't hear anything from him for several weeks, I guess. And so out of nowhere, one day I get an email, and it's got a private link to a new game of Coda's.
Oh.
This one is called The Tower, and to my knowledge, it's the last game that Coda ever made. So let's take a look.
Uh-oh. So, The Tower. Oh my god. Alright, The Tower. Oh, man. Alright. We're in the tower.
And this is where I have trouble saying anything meaningful about Coda's work. Because more than anything else, the tower just feels distant.
It does, yeah.
It feels
yeah.
like it's trying to distance itself from the world. It's a very
man.
Cold game.
It's cold, yeah. It's really fucking eerie, too. Jesus. Like, all the sounds and stuff in the background, the music and everything. Oh, I see. It's just like another...
This room actually has a maze in it.
Really? Was it like... Oh, God.
Except that all the walls of the maze are invisible.
Oh.
And then every time you touch one of the walls, there's this awful flashing and noise. So the experience is really miserable.
Oh, it is.
The game goes beyond not being meant to be played. It actually seems to despise the player for trying to play it at all.
Oh, man.
But I do want to show you the rest of the level, so when you're ready to continue, press enter, and I'll put a bridge over the maze.
Okay, I'm pressing enter. All right, here's the bridge. Nice bridge, by the way. It's really good. Okay, so we're bridging over the maze. Oh, man. This is, like, such a sad story, isn't it? Because, like, some of the first games were, you know, like, kind of
it's
fun.
It's not like
and...
this is the first game that's needed some modification to be playable. Like the house cleaning game. You know, that one used to actually loop the cleaning chores and you just cleaned a house forever. I had to cut it off so that you could exit the house and the game would actually end. But
yeah.
That game had an idea that it was actually trying to communicate. What's the deeper idea behind the invisible maze?
It's just that it never ends. That you can never get through
it. The only way past this challenge is to randomly guess the 6-digit code.
Oh my god.
Like the invisible maze, it's frustrating to me. Because it's the opposite of everything else that Coda has made. It doesn't encourage thought or engagement.
No, it's random.
It doesn't ask anything of me, except a lot of my time. If I could have reached him during this time, then maybe I could have asked him. But I couldn't. I still don't really understand why this is here. I'll put the code on the ground for you here, though, so that we can move on.
Okay, so it's 151617. 151... 617. Okay. Switch. Thanks for the code. Alright, so this is... I mean... The fact that, like, this stuff happens is... It's impressive, though, right? Like, you can tell that, like, a great deal of, like, time and effort goes into this. Because look at, like, all, like, the lighting... Like, all of this stuff, building all of this stuff takes time. Like, he's had to come up with the ideas for all this stuff to build it and everything. But, yeah, like, I guess at the same time, he's sort of exhibiting sort of anger and frustration with
the switch to open this door is actually on the other side of the door, meaning that it's literally impossible to solve from this side. So even if you somehow brute-forced your way through the first two challenges and you got to this point, there's actually just no way to progress.
He seems to be, it's like,
scary.
Obsessed with this idea, right?
Coda cutting himself off entirely. Just saying, you know, that's it. That's the end of the conversation. Not giving me any way to fix the problem. I feel like a failure, I guess, when I can't fix the problem.
Ah, it's really...
I can open this door for you, so let me do that.
Okay, I'm ready. Oh, shit. Okay.
Was I a failure for not understanding this game? I mean, I don't know why I would be. It's not like... Everything needs to have a solution, but I feel it somehow.
Well,
I feel like I failed, and I don't understand why. I remember, it's June of 2011, I'm playing this for the very first time, and as I'm playing, I'm thinking to myself, I don't know this person. I have no idea who this person is. It wasn't the guy I knew, it wasn't my friend. I had come to so many conclusions from looking at all of his work up to this point, and then suddenly none of them... I had been trying to, though. That was the thing. For years, I was trying to get to know him, to understand who he actually was and what he stood for. I asked him so many times to please just tell me what his games mean to him. I asked him please to tell me what the three dots mean.
Oh, yeah, the three dots.
And he wouldn't.
Well... It's weird, though, because I guess with this, like...
I just felt so strongly that if I could have connected with him, that if I could have somehow made his work my own, that I would finally be once and for all happy. It was that I needed to see myself in someone else. I needed to be someone other than me.
But he's providing you...
But he stopped and left. And it felt somehow like I had failed.
Well, maybe... He's providing these insights through these games, though. I mean, if he'd never shared this with anyone, like, he's shared it with the guy narrating right now.
Up?
I don't know if it's his fault, but, So he shared this with him, and it's, you know, it seems like, "Dear Davy, thank you for your interest in my games. I need to ask you not to speak to me anymore."
I'm the reason that you stopped making games, aren't I? It's because of what I did. I poisoned it for you.
What? How did he poison it? Just because he had a different idea of what games should be?
I don't think I ever told you this, but when I took your work and I was showing it to people, it actually felt... it felt as though I were responsible for something important and valuable.
Huh. I wonder at times whether you think I'm making these games for you. I get the feeling that he is making the games for him at this point. You've so infected my personal space
and
that it's possible I did begin to plan.
The people who played them, they treated me like I was important. They really listened and cared about what I had to say. Even though I was showing your work, I felt good about myself. Finally, for a moment, while I had that, I liked myself.
If there was an answer meaning, would it make you any happier? Would you stop taking my games and showing them to people against my wishes? Giving them something that is not yours to give? Violating the one boundary that keeps me safe? Would you stop changing my games? Stop adding lampposts to them? Oh. He was adding the lampposts. Would you simply
and
let them
be? And then you stopped.
What they are?
I didn't have anything left to show people.
Oh.
I just had to be with myself. And as soon as that happened, there was no feeling at all. Nothing. Less than nothing. What does that mean?
When I am around you, I feel physically ill. You desperately need something and I cannot give it to you. I literally do not have it. Struggling to come up with new ideas is not making me depressed. Low points are just a part of the process. The fact that you think I am frustrating or broken says more about you than about me. Oh my gosh. Okay. I realize that this just doesn't make sense to you just yet. Which is fine. You're not my problem to solve. Oh, I see. It's like he's doing a reversal, but I do hope that one day it clicks and that you make peace with this thing that you are wrestling.
I'm afraid that I did something really stupid because I don't like myself.
Yeah. And when you finally see what I am talking about, don't say anything. Here we go. Oh. Hey, there's no switch. Stuck.
That's why I'm releasing this collection of your work. Is because I haven't been able to find any other way to reach you. I've tried everything.
Oh, fuck.
And so a part of me has hope that if I put this compilation out into the world, and if I put my name on it, that maybe enough people will play it so that it'll find its way to you, so that I can tell you that I'm sorry. I know I screwed up. If I apologize to you truly and deeply, will you start making games again? Please. I need to feel okay with myself again. And I always felt okay as long as I had your work to see myself in. I mean, is something wrong with me? Because I know that I did an awful thing.
What the fuck?
And I'm doing it again right now. Like, I'm showing people your work, but I can't stop myself from doing it. That's how badly I need to feel something again. Like I'm an addict. There has to be something wrong with me.
Oh, my God.
Can I apologize? What if I tell you I was wrong? Will that work? Will that fix it? I don't know. I don't think it will, but there's nothing else that I can do. Just tell me what you want. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Please, start making games again. Please help me. Please give me some of whatever it is that makes you complete. I want whatever that wholeness is that you just summoned out of nothing and you put into your work. You were complete in some way that I never was. And I want to know how to be a good person. I want to know how not to hate myself. Please. I'm fading, and all I want is to know that I'm going to be okay.
Oh man, that's so fucked up. That is so fucked up. Holy shit. Oh my god, that was crazy. That was fucking crazy. Hey, nice. Okay. I wonder if this is just it. Maybe it just like ends here. Oh, here. Here we go. It's a nice train.
More love, more praise, more people telling me that I'm good. Always more. It's like a disease.
Fuck. Can you get onto a train? Or maybe you don't have to. Maybe you have to go like in front of the train. Can you go like this way? Is there a door over here? No, you can't go down here. Oh man. Oh, there's the open one. Trust me, right? Blaringly obvious. Nope. Can't figure it out. Shit. Oh look, you can hear people, but there's no people.
Solution.
Man, this is so fucked up. What a twist. Holy shit.
I guess if someone had told me ahead of time that he just really enjoyed making prison games, maybe I wouldn't have thought he was so desperate. I wouldn't have told so many people that he was depressed. Maybe he just likes making prisons.
Maybe. This is like so fucking creepy. Holy
shit.
Even
now, the disease is telling me to stop. Don't show people what a shitty person you are. They'll hate you.
Uh-oh. It was all this sand. And can we actually go through here? I guess you can. Or is it just like a... Oh. We're in. Oh, shit. Where are we now? The fuck? Hello? 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 Oh my god.
If I knew that my life depended on finding something to be driven by other than validation, what would that even be? It's strange, but the thought of not being driven by external validation is unthinkable. Like, I actually cannot conceive of what that would be like.
Oh, man. Can I actually go in here?
What now?
I think I just navigate this little pathway.
Get up. I think I need to go.
Okay.
And I'm sorry, because I know that I said that I would be here and I would walk you through this, but I'm starting to feel like I have a lot of work to do.
Oh, okay. That's fine.
I have a lot that I need to make up for. And so I'm just gonna...
Peace out?
Okay.
Okay. It's all right. I can do it. I'll get to the end. It's fine. Oh, man. Shit. Did he actually go? Hey, what's all this stuff? Oh, is this like a little... I guess we go down here. I think he is actually gone. Holy fuck. This game is... Just... I'm kind of speechless. It's really cool though. God, it's... Oh look, we start back here. Or is this the same place, actually? No, it just looks similar, but they didn't have this big staircase last time. Oh, I see. Okay, it's that, it's the beam, the whisper machine. Is that going to be... Is the whisper machine, like, related to the machine? Is it the same machine? I guess we'll eventually find out. Oh, man. Is that... No, it is just a really, really long hallway. Okay, fine. And at the end is... power source for the whisper machine that can be stopped by me stepping into it and possibly floating. Yeah. Floating up and... Oh, yeah. It's like a huge fucking labyrinth. Holy shit. Jesus. Wow. It's just like an endless Death Star, pretty much. That's pretty fucking cool.
Turn by.
4R. Oh my god. This project would not have been possible without the following individuals. Alright. Well, it's probably the longest evening with Sips ever. But well worth it. We walked through the whole thing. That was amazing. That was really, really well done. Really amazing. It's kind of like the first time you watched Memento. Remember the movie Memento? You got to the end of the movie and you were like, hang on, I just need to like sit down and think about this. I feel the same way about this right now. I enjoyed that immensely though. It's really, really, really sort of a dark point, definitely. But really compelling and just really, really well put together. Holy shit. That was very, very, very enjoyable. Well, for me anyway. I don't know if you feel the same. You'll have to let me know. Let me know on Reddit or in the comment section or whatever. I'd be interested to hear what you think about all this. Really good stuff. You can pick this up on Steam. It just came out yesterday. I mean, it's fairly short, but it's definitely worth going through if you like this kind of thing. And if it hasn't been completely and utterly spoiled by me playing through it. But if you've only watched, like, the first couple of minutes of it and you feel like you want to experience it for yourself, that is completely understandable, and I would highly recommend you do that as well. If not, excuse some of the some of my stupid jokes in between while everything was happening. But I definitely think that there's a message in that game. And it's definitely one that sort of... kinda... Does it resonate? I suppose it does in a way, actually. But yeah, definitely worth sort of thinking about and having some time to yourself to reflect. The Beginner's Guide. I'm really glad I picked that up. Like I said, I massively enjoyed the Stanley Parable, which was a lot goofier than this, obviously. But this just told such an interesting story and had such an excellent twist at the end. And wow, that was just fantastic. I mean, think of it as just like playing through a movie, like a really good movie with like an awesome story and not something that you're entirely used to or something that you've ever even really seen before. That was just really, really good. Excellent. All right. Well, hope you enjoyed that. Let me know. There's nothing to come back and play again because it's done. But, you know, let me know what you thought of it. We could talk about it on Reddit or Twitter, whatever. And I will see you next time for the next Evening with Sips. Thanks for watching, and see you later!